Welcome to class. My name is Abednego Mashone, and in this video, I shall be teaching you how to create and manage your Google Classroom. First, you need to have a Google account. Then, you need to sign in, then click on those 9 buttons. Scroll down to where you see your Google Classroom. Then, it will open. Once you get here, if you've created any class before, it will appear there, but since you are just a starter, it wouldn't come up. So this is a class that I've already created before now. You click on this plus button, you can see join class or create class, but in this case, we're going to be creating a class. So here you can choose to register for a school or for your personal use. You don't need to click for that for a school, you need to click for your personal use and continue. Click on continue. Right, so this time around, this point, you type in your name, the name of the class you want to create. It is always good that the class should reflect, the name of the class should reflect what it's all about. All right, like in this one, I'm creating it with the name My Webinar. Right, now after that, you need to click on the section to edit it. You may leave it out, it's not really important, but then I want to put in Nego 2020. You move on to your subject, what you want to teach, you put it in, you put it in there. That is I want to put in there now my training room number. You can put anything there. What room is that? You can name it Emerald. Let if it's a school, then you click on create. You can leave it blank. Now it's your class is being created. Now you wait for it to be created. It takes a few seconds and it's all done. Waiting for our class to be created, and soon it will be created. So now the class is created. Once you get here, Google will even be taking you through so many of the processes that you need to know. Here you have your code that you can use to invite any student to your class. So this is the code for this class. Now you give it to anybody that has a Google account or whatever, he could easily join the class with this code. How to use this code, I will show you in a subsequent video. Choose to make it can you click on that to make it cover the whole screen, and you can exit it from there. Great. There in your classroom, you have the button for different functions like your classwork, your people. Here you add people to your classroom, such as teachers and students. Then here now you need to click here. Good, we want to add teachers and students to our class. So here you can click on that to add a teacher who can also teach when you're not there. You can do everything. He has the right of every teacher. So what you do here, you type in the email of the teacher that you want to invite, and once you've typed it in there, it will come up and you're all set. You add it. Yes, imagine there. Now good, you can add as many teachers as you want to your classroom. This time around, we want to invite another teacher, okonkwo@gmail.com, Mr. Okonkwo. Then we need to add his email for him to be invited. Yes, click on yes, add. So thereafter you go on to create to invite. Once you invite them, an email will be sent to them telling them to click to accept the proposal. Now we need to add our students. Same process we used to add the teacher, that's what we're going to use to add the student as well. Now once the students get the email, there is a button in the email that they will click on that will take them directly to the classroom. Now yes, we've added coolnego@gmail.com. We want to add another student to it. This student email is chomediatv@gmail.com. right, yes, coming up. Yes, click, and that has been added. You click on invite. Once you click on the invite, the interface will be closed. Then you see the people you've invited in this page. Then you can then move. Let's move on to classwork. Here in classwork, you can create so many things like assignments, quiz, questions, materials, or you can reuse a post. Here you can share any information with your students. But there we need to do is do some settings for us for our class now. Now here, this we've already done this setting ever since. You can describe your class, but it's not really important as such. What is really important, this is your code that you use to invite. But what I really want to show to you now is how to make sure that your class is organized. Here, you can choose to make it that your student can post and comment, but then I prefer you setting it to student can only comment, because by the time you make it a student can post and comment, they will turn your class upside down, especially when you are dealing with children. They will abuse the privilege, so it's better you do that way. So you, once you get here, everything is quite very intuitive to learn. All the big settings are what you can see right there. You click on save when you're done with your setting. It's time to change the look of our classroom, and this the look of it, you can change it to any picture of your choice. Then here now you can choose to change the theme. You click on select theme to change the picture there. You click now, you see several images will be shown, and you could pick any of them. Now let's pick this. Click on select theme. Good, the theme has been selected. It will load. You see it has changed. But then you also can upload your personal picture that you've already created and saved in your system. Simply go there, get it, and upload. Now you select it, click on open. Right, you see your file is being uploaded. Right. Now you need to drag the crop function to make sure that all the part of your pictures that you want to show in the banner, that is the wallpaper, appear in it. So, but the what I've actually designed is actually the type that should fit in. Yes, all I need to do is just to drag and let it fit in. Good. Now, as a student, to join the classroom, you need to go to your email. From your Google account here, you click on those 9 buttons, you go to where your Gmail is. Scroll up, yes, you go to your Gmail, you click on it, let it open. Once it opens, you see the invite email that has been sent to you. You wait for it to open. Yes, it has opened. Look at the email there. Now you click on it to open. And here you see the invite that has been sent. Hello, Fortman Media. Yes, good. You click on the join button. You click on the join button. Yes, and it will take you straight to the classroom. Now the next thing I want to teach you is how you're going to create activities for your students as a teacher. Oh, here on the stream, you click on classwork, click on the classwork, click on create. Here you can give them assignments and several other things, but in this we need to give them materials. Then you type in the name of the material you want, the title of the material. Thereafter you can put a description, but if you don't want, it's optional. Then you click on add to add file from your Google Drive or whatever, or to upload. Click on the upload button. There are several things you can do there. You can select the file you want. After selecting the file you want, you click on OK or on open. The file will be added. Then you can now click on upload. But then if you've got something in your Google Drive already, you can now click on add. Now it's already there. Next thing to do, you click on topic. You need to create one if you've not created one before, or if you have written a new topic, you need to create a new topic for there, so that you can easily sort out the materials you've given to your student anytime you need it. It's very important what you do. You can also choose to select the student you want to give your assignment to. Let's assume some students have not paid. You can choose to work on that from here. If you're managing several classrooms, you can choose to give a certain to several classes. You can do it from that way. Then you cannot click on post, but then you can also schedule your material so that it is uploaded as at the time you want in future. You can set the time even for it to be uploaded in 10 years to come, so at the particular time as well. Once you've done that, you schedule and it's all set. After you've scheduled your work, you can see there that is already shown. It will show to you that it has been scheduled yet. You also can still edit it. Yeah, you cannot change anything. You need to adjust. Let's assume you made a mistake. You can do the adjustment there, and you can also choose not to schedule it anymore. You cancel it, then you post it, and it will be posted immediately. It will ask you if you want to post it now. You can click on post for it to be posted. So it is very flexible. Now you go back, you go to the stream, you see it over there in the stream that a material has been posted, and your student will be able to see it at any time. On the stream, you can communicate with your student. You can reply their comments individually. Like this person just asked me a question if he could write the assignment I've given to him on a sheet of paper then sent to me, and I said yes, you can. Once you finish writing what you've got to write, you click on the send button and it's sent immediately. Which, if you have a good internet connection. Now you should know that right here you can post links to different or other online platforms that you want to use for delivering your lectures. Here you can post the link to your Skype meeting, Zoom meetings, or Google Meet, or Duo, whichever you want. You can post any link, even YouTube video links can also be posted here as well. And you as a student, you will be able to see the things that your teacher has posted as well. Like here now, you can see if it's a YouTube link and you are working from your system, you don't really need to leave the Google Classroom for you to watch the video. It will just play right in there once you click on it. That's how it works, and you view the video, and both you and your teacher and other students can view it simultaneously, that is at the same time. That's how it works. And I think we shall call it a day at this point. I believe you've got all you really need to know, the basics of Google Classroom. So in my next video, I shall be teaching you some other aspect of online lectures. Thank you for being there. Once more, my name is Abednego Omashone. Do have a nice day.